Hello friends, this is Sanjay with Liazon Marketing. I hope you guys are doing well. So let's talk about the error codes 8572, 85, blah, blah, blah. Okay, what is the error codes about basically? It's very simple. You know, GS1 and Amazon have come together for a long time and they want people to put a validated GS1 barcode, you know, a validated UPC barcode. Back in the days, we used to buy it from eBay, from many places to avoid paying, you know, it's like $30 a code, man. Just piece of numbers is $30 from GS1, but it is what it is. So I used to buy from Barcodes, Talk. I bought from a few other different agencies in the past. I mean, I still buy, but you know, sometimes some numbers can slide by, but a lot of times you end up with a code like this. See, 8572 is basically saying that you need to provide authentication, that the codes that you're using are actually authenticated GS1 barcodes. Listen, I have like, this seller has like, I don't know, more than 100 products. So if they keep on buying 30 bucks a pop, that's a lot of money. But anyways, it is what it is, and we just got to deal with it. Okay, so let's say, for example, you purchased a barcode from one of these vendors. Like, I use Barcodes Talk. I mean, I've been using them for a long time. And I never had an issue until recently. I went into issues. I'm not saying it's 100% correct, but recently I went into issues. So basically what Barcodes Talk does, what I've noticed that a lot of other agencies don't do it. These guys, they actually give you a GS1 certificate, like the one you see behind my back. Let me just move over. I did for one of my customers. So the certificate, basically what happens is you have to first, when you get this code, you are going to take a screenshot of this whole message right here. Maybe just, you know, reduce it. Take a screenshot of this message. Take a screenshot of the product you're carrying. Take a screenshot of the list of UPC codes that you're using. So I buy in thousands. So when I bought 1,000 of them, if one is showing, then definitely also I send them the whole list. I say, look, this is what the problem is. This is what you need to get fixed. Okay. So you're going to take screenshot of the error message. You're going to take screenshot of your product, what you're trying to do. Image is even better. Screenshot of the UPC code. So if you are using several UPC codes, make sure to take a screenshot of each, because each product is different. Even though it's showing the same, it's just building more variations, you know. So you just show this, so your GTIN certificate, you're not going to do it. Barcodes Talk is going to speak directly with Amazon. That's what I like about their service. You know, they're excellent. You just got to give them the proofs and then they go into Seller Central and they validate the codes for you. And once it's validated, then you're good to go. Let's see what else we got here. So this is how the certificate looks like. You know, we purchased like 1,000 of them. I would say to you, we used about 300 from this list, and we had no issues. The other 700, we tried like about 150, 200, and none of them started working. So, you know, don't have time to like keep on pouring. So that's why we reached out to Barcodes Talk, and we explained them the situation. This is perfectly fine. Send whatever stuff you can. You know, they give you a whole list. Let me show you. Here you go. So this is their support is amazing. Their support is really amazing and it's excellent. So they will give you, you know, they will tell you what to do when you have certain, you know, error codes, and you click on them, and then they will help you, they will guide you, they'll give you their support, and take it from there. Once it's authenticated on Amazon, there's no problem. You can just go and you can use it. Okay, very simple. I'm going to attach this file to the channel, to the video. So this way you can upload it. And if you want to buy from them, you're more than welcome to purchase. The prices are really good. I would not recommend you buy maybe, you know, single barcodes because it gets kind of expensive. But if you buy in thousands, I think I paid like $180 for a thousand. It's like about 18 cents a piece. It's not bad, you know. But see, one barcode is $5. Five is $10. So you got to go up. You can buy as many as you like. Me, I just, because we use it so many times for so many customers that we need to constantly, you know, get the best price. And most of our customers are like selling over 300, 500 products at a time. So it's always better to buy more, because if one of your products sells good, you can always expand it into variations. So then you will need the barcodes again, you know. So that's what, you know, I prefer that my clients sell products with variations. Could be size, could be material, could be colors, anything in variations, but you know, always good to have some extra. But coming to the main point, this is the original piece right here. This is where you should be buying all your barcodes. If you purchase over here in the past, just reach out to the company you purchase from and then have them fix the issue for you. I'm sure they're all going to help you. They're good people out there. But here, GS1, you got to get your barcodes. Very similar process. They are also going to give you a certificate of the GTIN assignment. You got to give it to Amazon. You got to show them what you're doing and give it to Amazon. And then, so basically, this is registering your company and your product that you're selling. You go to GS1. Now, this is highly recommended by Amazon. Okay, so it's the safest way, the best way without running into any issues. And then you go get GTIN code. And once you have the code, get your barcode, estimate how many barcodes you need. So you see, here you go. Sizes, three colors. So if you have variations, then you got to, for each variation, you got to buy three times three times three. Okay, 81 barcodes. You just can't buy one. Each color is one barcode. Each size is one barcode. Each material is one barcode. Each package is one barcode. So if you have a product that has three sizes, so the product one, the three sizes, three. And then if you have each of the size in three different colors, then for small, you got one, two, three. For medium, you got one, two. And for large, you got one, two, three. You understand? Three times three is nine. Simple. See, three here. For each, you're going to add three. It's going to be nine. Then the styles. If you have three different styles, you're going to add another three. That's 27. And if you have three different packages, medium, large, small, and 27 times 3 is 81. So you got to purchase 81 barcodes. Okay, so let's see. 10, 100. So around 81 is going to cost you $750. I bought 1,000 for $180 with the other guys. Okay, and then there's a renewal fee. Look at this. They have subscriptions also. They, you know, the business, look, if you want to run a business, the money is not in the fees. The money is in the subscription, because that keeps you going around every single year, every single month. You know, that's how the business is. And technology, the digital world is all about subscriptions. So that's how companies stay in business. Because if you have 100 or 1,000 customers, that adds up. Now GS1 wants every Amazon seller to purchase from GS1. Just imagine, man, it's just a turnover for them. Never go out of business. It's like that. But anyways, it's their business. That's how they run their business, and that's how we get to learn how we want to interact. So same thing. If you're selling a product on Amazon, make sure to sell a product that you can subscribe. You know, something with a subscription. And then you know that every month you will get the orders coming in for the, like, for example, I was looking at this product. I mean, I buy a lot of envelopes for my other business, which is I do business brokerage also. I sell businesses online, offline, brick and mortar. But the thing is, you know, I have to do a lot of marketing and advertising there. But if you purchase these, like this guy right here, he doesn't have a subscription. But if you look at others, they have a subscription. So you go and Amazon offers you a 5% discount if you subscribe up to five products. Every month you get, you know, you see one-time purchase. And then if you want subscribing this. Now, what happens in the subscription is many times you forget about, you know, you say, I don't want it. And the catch about subscription is, you can always boost your price up. Like if somebody bought for $18.99 this month, next month you make it $19.99. People don't know, and a lot of people don't even care. But going back to going back to GS1, this is what you pay. Okay, they will give you a certificate of this one, and if you ever run into this problem, you will have to follow the same procedure. You have to show your product, what you're selling. You got to show this one. You have to show the certificate that you're going to get from GS1, okay? And then you are going to go to Seller Central. Seller Central, and you are going to, let me just save this work as draft, because it took me a lot of time to fix this listing. Let me see. Again. So after you save, just make sure you save it as draft. Otherwise, you're going to lose everything that you did. And why is it letting me? One second. That's the best way. That's why I love technology. It's so fast. Boom. You don't have to go in and sign up every time you're doing this stuff. You go under help and you're going to ask for support. Selling a service. The best way to reach Amazon is forget all of this, because if you go after this, then it's just going to take you to like several different steps, and you just write here. GTIN code not working. And product, you see, listing exemptions, fix error mess. Again, you're going to do my error is not listed, because what you want to do is you want to contact seller support. You know, you don't want to play around with these. I mean, who has time to read all that stuff there? FBA account related. My issue is not related. Product or listing related. And that's it. There you go. You just go boop, boop, boop. Even if the issue is related, don't select that. Just go hit them straightforward. And then the best way is email takes a long time. chat, forget it. Phone call is the best. You put your number here and you just, my issue is urgent and this one, and schedule the call. And listen, be very polite to these people, please. I beg you, because these guys that are handling the support for Amazon, no comments, but but you want to be polite. Don't get upset with them. Don't get mad with them. You know, they're just doing their jobs. Okay, put it this way. It's not the best customer service out there, but they're just doing their jobs. They're following instructions from Amazon. You be polite. Sometimes, you know, I have learned big lesson with Amazon. I used to get so pissed off. I'm like, what is wrong with you idiots, man? Why can't you just fix the issue? But I learned the hard way, okay? If you are polite and sweet and thankful, your work is going to be done in the matter of seconds. If you're going to be harsh, aggressive, forget it. They're just going to keep you in the loop. So, all right, put your phone number there, which country you're from, select this, schedule a call, or instead of schedule, do this one. Call me now. I want to get this thing fixed up right now. All right, so that's about it. And then you're going to call them and you're going to tell them that, listen, I have the authentication certificate of this, and they're going to tell you that you just follow the protocols. They're going to tell you what to do. You finish up everything, send it to them, and that's it. Simple as that. And 99.999% you will get approved. Once it gets approved, then you don't have problem listing as many products as you want with those barcodes, okay? So I wish you guys all the best. And if you have any questions or concerns, let me know. But this is where you have to get your this one. GS1, this is what they recommend. All right, friends. Thank you so much and have a lovely day. Bye-bye.